Hello everyone, welcome back to my channel. So if you're new here, my name is Shimon and today I'm going to share my Wiccathon TBR. So Wiccathon is a monthly readathon that is happening in August, so tomorrow, and this is created by Yati Takate. So I will link her channel and the announcement video down below on my description box. But basically this is a dedication to Filipino authors. And we have 8 props, so let's start. From is Filipino SFF. So read a science fiction or fantasy book by Filipino authors. So with this one, I'm going to pick Ta-da! By Katrina F. Olan. So I'm really much excited about this book. Since pa lang na dumating to sa akin nung last book haul ko. But basically, this is a sci-fi novel and set in the Philippines. So I'm really much excited about this. So this is gonna be the first book talaga na mabasahin ko this week at all. Second one is Filipino LGBTQIA+. So read a book by a LGBTQIA+ Filipino author. So with this one, I'm going to pick The Bone Witch by Lynn Chepeco. I actually googled her and sabi niya doon is she described herself as pansexual. So I'm really much excited with The Bone Witch because the story about witches, curses, resurrection, and I know this is a dark fantasy with I think trilogy, so it's gonna be the second prompt in my Wiccathon. So The Bone Witch. Third one is new to me. So read a book by a Filipino author whose book you never read before. So lahat na lang to kasi hindi ko pa nababasa lahat ng any Filipino books. Dito dito is Kawalhati Bautista Books, which is Bata-Bata Paano Ka Ginawa at Dekada 60. Ta-da! So the fourth prompt is The Modern Pinoy. So read a book by a Filipino author set in present-day Philippines. So with this one, I'm going to pick Patron Saints of Nothing by Randy Ribe. So I'm pretty much excited about this story. This has been on my TBR for so long and I'm glad that I'm going to dive into this book. The fifth one is The Filipino Diaspora. So read a book by a diaspora Filipino author. So with this one, I'm going to pick Something in Between by Melissa de la Cruz. So Something in Between is we follow our main character, which is Jasmine de los Santos, who is 16 years old, and her whole life she has been working hard with her studies to get a scholarship and make her Filipino immigrants proud. So everything has changed when her parents revealed that their visa has been expired years ago, so their entire family is now illegal, and with that there will be no college, no scholarship, and a threat of deportation. So I'm pretty much excited about this story, and I think this fit in the diaspora prompt. So the next prompt is Stupid Love.
Nung mailove ako sa iyo, kalong pag-ibig mo ay tunay, pero di rin nagtagalumasin ang tunay na kulay.
Sino yun? So Stupid Love is read a romance book by a Filipino author. So with this one, I'm going to pick Lumayo Ka Nga Sa Akin by Bob Ong. So I really much excited about this because Bob Ong to, and yeah, so yun. So the seventh prompt is Sariling Wika. So read a book in a Filipino language. So it's either Tagalog, Bisaya, Waray, or etc. So with this one, I'm going to pick Sadyano Silang Book 1 and 2. So I'm pretty much excited about to read this because wala akong nakitang bad reviews dito. And based sa comments na babasa ko or nabasa ko sa Goodreads is parang it's somehow a touch of like Harry Potter and Percy Jackson vibe, so I'm not really sure, but you know, I'm pretty much excited about this because all of the things that I've read sa comments is puro positive, so this is gonna be on my sariling wika prompt. The last prompt is host choice. So read a book recommended by any of the hosts. So with this one, I'm not really sure kung ano pang mabasahin ko dito, but I think nakita ko sa Wiccathon that Gerald the Bookworm and Julian is they recommend any Bob Ong book. So with this one, ito muna ang aking TBR, which is Aba Nakakabasa Na Pala Ako by Bob Ong. And I'm pretty much excited about this because naging movie na siya. And yeah, so this will be temporarily will be in my 8th prompt.
So upon checking sa pag-open ng Bob Ong book, so na-realize ko na meron pala akong free bookmark sa harap at saka sa likod. So wala lang, share ko lang.
Other than that is meron din ako nito, so Project 17, so babasahin ko rin to during August, so kasama ko na rin siya, but hindi ko lang kung saan ko siya ilalagay na prompt, but I will also read this because I think hindi ko lang kung anong kwento nito, but I'm pretty much excited about this, so yeah. These are the books that I'm planning to read during the Wiccathon, so thank you for watching, and if you like this video, give it a thumbs up, and if you wanted to see more about my bookish side, you can click subscribe, and I will see you on my next video. Bye! Bye.